The Pirelli World Challenge reaches the midpoint of its historic 25th anniversary season and celebrates with one of its hallmarks, variety. Revs coming up, we're green!
Big boom coming off the three.
Two, three, four, breast in some spots.
Side-by-side action.
He absolutely nailed it.
Three-way battle.
And we've got an incident. You would expect nothing less.
Oh, clips the inside apex.
Very racy.
This is going to get into
side. That
look
is a brave move. What a pop. This is what World Challenge is all about.
The intense competition continues here at the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Challenge, presented by StopTech. Hi, everybody, and welcome. I'm Greg Creamer. As always, my broadcast partner is Calvin Fish. Cal, diversity, Toronto to Mid-Ohio.
And Greg, this track is certainly equally challenging. Mid-Ohio is a driver's favorite for a number of reasons. It offers low-speed technical turns, elevation change, and some high-speed turns, which will certainly test the limits of both the cars and the drivers here this weekend.
Here at Mid-Ohio, this is a completely different challenge for these guys.
This is one of the best road courses in all of North America. It's very technical in some of the turns. It's got some really high-speed stuff. And it's got some good overtaking opportunities as well.
Well, for a look at our Cadillac Key Corners, let's get an onboard lap with none other than Andy Pilgrim. Enjoy the ride.
I'm Andy Pilgrim, and this is your Cadillac Key Corners from Mid-Ohio. Coming into turn one, fifth gear, down to fourth gear, through this corner, very fast corner, about 100 miles an hour in the middle of this corner. Coming out, got a straight shot up to turn two, the old keyhole area, uphill braking zone, long right-hander coming up, hard on the brakes, coming in here. It's very slippery in the middle, got a little more grip on the exit, critical to get a good return out of this turn two, but you got a long straightaway. Long straightaway, downhill straightaway in the middle. There's kind of a kink. They call that turn three. It's really not a kink. It's not a corner. Coming down to turn four. Again, it's all downhill into turn four. Sixth gear down to third gear. Heavy, heavy braking downhill. Right-hander, turn four through turn four. Coming up to turn five, up and over the hill here. The car goes light. Back end goes light right there. Heavy braking down for six. Get it turned in. And now there's an amazing area up here through seven. Through over the hill here, we call this 7A, coming down towards 8. Again, right-hander up over the hill. The car goes light, back end twitches, the tires spin up a little bit. Coming down through turn 9 on the back, it's a little bit of a kink. Uphill braking into 10, another fast corner, around 90 miles an hour through here. Hard braking downhill again into this long carousel area, turn 11. Early on the power as much as you can, little left-hand kink under the straightaway, and that concludes your Cadillac Key Corners from Mid-Ohio.
Well, this track is a grin-inducing technical roller coaster ride. It is a joy. Cal, couple of overtaking areas, but one in particular is the best.
Absolutely, Greg, and the key for that is to get in a good position. You need a good launch out of the keyhole turn, turn two, down that back straightaway, through that slight kink, and then into our Mutual brake zone down here in turn four. You can carry a lot of speed through the apex here, and you can go side by side, so it's really a great place to watch the action from. What's really cool is you can continue that side by side action all the way up the hill into turn five and even down into turn six, so great action here today.
But if you get it wrong, see all that sand? That's called China Beach, and you'll spend some time in the sun over there. Let's take a look at our Mid-Ohio Moat Tool race analysis. Most importantly, a huge field across the two classes. You take a look at the track, 13 turns, a little over 2 miles. And Cal, those lap records, well, we've seen records fall virtually everywhere we've been. I'd expect the same here.
Absolutely. I mean, everyone seems to be up in their game at the moment.
Absolutely. Speaking of up in their game, K-Pax has a new McLaren on hand. Alex Figge makes his return. Big story.
It really is. It was a massive crash that he had there at Road America. They couldn't make the rounds at Toronto, but they're on site now with two of those McLarens. They're going to be tough here, I think.
Absolutely. That's one of our Pirelli storylines. How about Acura real-time Petey Cunningham returning with an all-wheel drive TLX GT rule car?
So much speculation about this car will contend when it does get here, and today is the day. It's going to be fun to watch.
Boy, I'll tell you what, that real-time team has been so good at Mid-Ohio, now an all-wheel drive battle. And the other big storyline, Ryan Dial in the effort Porsche.
Well, he's run at the front here before in World Challenge competition. He's going to be on it today.
So, folks, that sets up the scenario for what should be a fascinating couple of rounds here, rounds 11 and 12 of the Pirelli World Challenge GT, GTA, and GTS Championships. Speaking of our two divisions, remember GTA is a subdivision, let's check in on our Moat Tool Pole Award winners. In GT,
Mike Skeen getting his third pole of the season. Boy, has that team found form.
They absolutely have, and they need to right now. They're trying to chase down Johnny O'Connell for the championship.
And he got 7 points as a result. We'll talk more about that in a minute. Now, in the GTS category, almost remarkably, first pole of the season for the defending series champion, Lawson Aschenbach, in that Black Dog Speed Shop Camaro. Little BOP adjustment for them really seems to have helped.
Yeah, it doesn't take much, and it's certainly given them that little edge they need, and they're now back at the front of the pack. Great to see.
It is indeed. Well, that means it is time for us to go racing for round 11, folks. Let's get you down to the front of the grid for that very special command to set this race on its way.
Welcome to the Pirelli World Challenge presented by StopTech. On behalf of our friends at Pirelli Tire North America and Optima Battery, drivers, start your engines.
Well, I've said it many times, I love that sound, this orchestra from all these different instruments and the symphony that they play. We are about ready to get this going. As a matter of fact, there it is, the Cadillac pace car, that beautiful Cadillac CTS-V that our partners at Cadillac provide for our pace car is on its way as we are about to set this field in position. And we've got a lot to talk about in this field, Cal, and some great stories. We touched on a couple of them in the Pirelli storylines, what they bear expanding on, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. Some fascinating scenarios could play out here this weekend. Both of our championship leaders are in trouble after qualifying. Johnny O'Connell back in seventh position on the grid, and Mark Wilkins the same position in the GTS field. So they're over 100 points in front right now, but if you run the tables here this weekend, one of their championship charges coming through, if they can do that and run the table and sweep, boy, oh boy, they're going to be a big swing in the points here.
Yeah, that 100 points thing sounds huge, but you can win 140 on a weekend and more if you get that pole, so it can change. We also talked about the return of Alex Figge, but that's a great story in and of itself, especially where he ended up qualifying. But the Capex team here, boy, do they look stout.
They look really good. At one point, they had the front row locked out, and suddenly Mike Skeen jumped up and grabbed the pole position away and those bonus points. But what a story for Alex Figge. Huge wreck at Road America. They rebuilt the car, missed the Toronto rounds. He's back at a track he loves, Greg. He won both rounds here last year. The Capex team have the notebook on this track, but it's a new race car they're bringing this year. They had the Volvos last year. That was a very strong car for this circuit. But that McLaren, suddenly they're starting to find the sweet spot. I spoke to Alex this morning. He said, we're taking bigger swings at the setup. The championship essentially for me is over. So we can take a few more risks and it's paying off.
And quickly on Mike Skeen getting the pole, you were telling me off, Mike, that that's allowed them to make a little bit of a setup adjustment.
Well, yesterday in practice, they are playing with the downforce levels on the Audi. The Audi really likes the downforce and take advantage of the braking zones and attacking the corners. He said yesterday, we were thinking about if we didn't have good track position, as in a good grid spot, we'd probably take some downforce out so we can pass down the straightaways. Now starting on the pole, he can run that downforce in the car. He's going to be tough to beat today.
Boy, it's going to be fun to watch this one unfold. And there's a look at our Cadillac safety car, the Escalade, that will chase the field on the opening lap just in case there's incidents. We hope that we just get to see this beautiful vehicle parked on the side. That's where we like to see this one. But again, our huge thanks to the folks at Cadillac.
One of the things with our racing program that we love to do is when we come to an event, to showcase our vehicles. And now typically, we're always talking about our performance V-Series models, but we've got some great new cars in the showroom this fall. New Cadillac ELR, an electric vehicle from Cadillac that went on sale in December. The all-new iconic 2015 Cadillac Escalade that's just hitting dealerships right now. And then the ATS Coupe, which will be in dealerships a little bit later this summer. Again, adding to that lineup of the ATS sedan. So trying to give the buyers, trying to give the fans a little bit more than just performance, but that whole Cadillac lineup. What we like to say is there's a little bit of V in every car we sell. And when you look at the dynamic capability we've built into the cars, and you look at kind of the fit and finish that we put into the cars, I think people are seeing that kind of transcend the lineup.
And that leads us into our Kia Quad Box, Cal, featuring some amazing images from these GoPro cameras.
And it's going to be awesome around this Mid-Ohio sports car course. I mean, with the elevation changes, this is going to be some cool action here this afternoon.
Yeah, these four shots and many more coming at you thanks to GoPro. We're so lucky to have them on all these cars. Well, folks, there are the last few cars stacking into position. We are ready to go. Round 11. It's the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Challenge presented by StopTech. Round 11 of the Pirelli World Challenge GT GTS Championship. This one should be something else. What an amazing field. The green flag flies at the back of the grid. We are ready to go.
Key is for those caddies sitting on the fourth and fifth row of the grid. They need to get a great launch here.
Watching for the signboards and the light sequence to come up. I love this moment. The anticipation builds. The standing start. Here we go. We're green. Oh, not a good start from the outside by Figgy. A superb launch by Steen. Dial slots around into second. And one of those caddies, Cal, I think he may have been up to third.
Yeah, I think that's O'Connell again, up to third spot as Dial puts the pressure on Skeen for the lead of this motor race. Figgy slots into fourth. Look at Lazaro, little touch there, up into the keyhole.
Yeah, that was he and Figgy just having a little bump and go, but slotting in, Thorne tucks in behind Lazaro. Good start there, and look at the launch for O'Connell, Cal.
Look at that, he has to make hay while he can. It's been an awesome start for our championship leader. He tries to take the second spot away from Ryan Dial as they head down into the break zone for turn four.
This is a track, if you know what you're doing. Oh, damage, something with
Thorne.
Yeah.
Thorne's got damage.
Right front corner, plume of smoke. I was gonna see if Dial, you can make an outside move there into the S's. He elected not to try it at this point, obviously. Early days, and the other thing to keep an eye on, folks, is that sky.
Yeah, the threatening clouds are getting closer and closer, and look at this. Who would have believed it? Johnny O'Connell is now putting on the pressure for the lead of this motor race.
Seventh to second, spectacular stuff as always. And there's Dial in that 31 effort racing Porsche, then a bit of a gap back to Figgy.
Skeen's going to be thinking, boy, oh boy, what a perfect weekend so far, until he looks in that rearview mirror and he sees the guy that he's chasing in the champ. Oh, Hanna's around.
Oh, and he's got to be very careful about rejoining.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, nasty squeeze play.
Oh, one of the Nissans hits the curb there and turns.
And that gets Stout as well. That's 57, Boucher, I believe, and Stout in the Lucas Oil Scion. Oh, boy.
Yes, that went to the right there as two cars tried to go around Marcelo Hahn there on the exit of turn 11.
Oh, and we got Hedman in the back. He's had a spin as well. So it's just going absolutely crazy right at the moment here. See if Hedman can get going. He does, Cal. The other two cars did clear themselves, so we may avoid a full course caution.
Yeah, it's certainly going to be difficult to get all of those cars out of the way. But look at this. The battle for the leads heats up. It's now a three-car train here at the front of the pack.
However, we now get word we have a full course yellow because one of the cars that stopped again right on the track surface. You see Brad Adams in the Voodoo Dat Dog machine down in the pits, and it was Hahn who had the spin. Looked like he was able to drive off Kel, and then it stopped.
Left rear
maybe
down.
Yeah.
Left rear has some damage there.
Boy, big wrinkle right there, right in front of the right rear tire for Brad Adams.
I wonder if maybe Marcelo Hahn may have had some contact that caused him to spin the car coming up over the hill here. If he's got a deflating left rear, it would certainly do it to him. But look at this. See that sign there, take to the grass. Oh,
boy, that was
big
a buzzer there. Ball. But,
yep.
And the Scion, when he got to the grass, it snapped right and then came right back around and spun him across into the wall. And a broken right rear corner on the Nissan. And so in a broken front and another rear. Oh, look at that, the right rear down on that Scion as well. Boy, this is a team that if the only luck they can get is bad, it seems.
Tough week for Rick Boucher. He's had electrical problems, really has hindered his time on the racetrack this weekend. So he went into qualifying with not a lot of knowledge of the race car.
So a number of cars, Landry having an issue. There is the 68 of Capaldi. A lot of cars parked around the track. We're gonna step away for just a moment while we get things sorted out and cleaned up here at the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Course. And as we go to break, we'll show you the current top four in each of our classes. All right, folks, welcome back. Once again, we are ready to go back to green here at the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Challenge, presented by StopTech. Pace car is in. Essentially, we're starting this race brand new after those incidents. It is now a single file rolling restart. We are green. Skeen gets a good jump, but so does Dial.
He doesn't look
to the inside, didn't he?
Look at Lazaro too. So yeah. Dial gets a position. Oh, look at Palmer forcing his way through there in turn one.
Boy, wow. Everybody just reading the other guy beautifully and making the move, but Skeen timed it to perfection. Butch Leitzinger now going to try a run on Andy Pilgrim in the Bentley in the back. He's going to get trapped on the outside, though, Cal. But you can do that here if you get that car planted well enough. Let's see what happens out of the keyhole, still side by side onto the back straight.
Well, two of the most road racers in the world right there going hard at it as Butch now flicks that Bentley to the inside on the Cadillac as they head down through turn three.
And Butch looks to have position. Dial takes a pick, or a look at making a pick on Skeen. Can't quite get it done. By the way, folks, our Optima Batteries best standing start, which happened before that caution. Rookie Jay Mattis, who had a problem in qualifying, started dead last, moved up seven spots in his VP Fuels Porsche. Congratulations. And Cal, speaking of moving up.
Wow, look at this. as Leitzinger and Pilgrim were sort of like trading the racetrack there. Sofronas took advantage and dived down the inside of Pilgrim as he now comes back on the attack.
Boy, Pilgrim just ran up on the back as well, and here we go. This is a great look, that battle between Lazaro and Palmer. Boy, they are in lockstep, aren't they? And they've been in this situation before. Remember Barber?
Yeah, certainly had a great battle there as the lead changed on the very final lap of that race. But Andrew Palmer is certainly an aggressive young driver. He's gone quiet a little bit here the last couple of rounds, but he's back on the attack right now, up into the top five.
He said that's frustrated him. He was really looking forward to getting to this track to be able to unleash things a little bit. There is your GTS leader from pole, Lawson Aschenbach in the Black Dog Speed Shop. That's the Chevrolet Camaro. Right behind him is Petey Cunningham, folks. That's that Acura TLX GT all-wheel drive machine. They're not quite where they want to be in terms of pace. Talk to Petey. He said they have a little issue they found with the front end of that car. He said once we solve that, he said we're going to be much more in the thick of it. We know what it is. We'll get it taken care of. You know they will.
They certainly will. They have such a great heritage in this championship, and that car is really cool when you look underneath the skin. See a lot of dust there flying off the keyhole corner, which is the corner you really need good traction to fly down this back straightaway with.
Boy, did Aschenbach get a great start. Obviously, before that caution, he had a couple of GT cars between himself and Andy Lee, and he now has himself a little bit of a margin, but now those GT cars have gone by. He might actually get held up a little bit here in the S's and in madness, and here comes Andy Lee in that Crown 7 Best IT Camaro.
Yeah, certainly that BOP change with that air restrictor has brought these Camaros to life. They run 1-2 right now.
Dean Martin in that picture car's East Mustang sitting in third. Dean Martin said this is one of his favorite tracks. He couldn't wait to get here either. Been awfully good, certainly, on those street courses, but showing some good form here. And Johnny O'Connell not letting Ryan Dial go.
You can never count Johnny O out. Certainly a lot more weight on that caddy. It brings that caddy to life a little bit quicker. But I think all of the GT3 teams too, Greg, are finding the sweet spot of how they get these Pirellis to come alive a little bit sooner in the run.
Very solid run in the early going here at the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Course. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. We are back at what is now a very wet Mid-Ohio Sports Car Challenge presented by StopTech. It just came out of nowhere, folks. We'd seen those clouds building, and look at this. Andy Lee just trying to get back around the track. As wet as it is, Cal, he got away with one here, but it is wet.
Yeah, this is actually under caution. We've already gone through a caution flag period here, and Andy Lee just got caught out. Remember, these guys were essentially on these Pirelli P0 slicks earlier. Look at this. Dean Martin down through China Beach. This is not a good feeling in the race car.
No, he gets into it. He gets away with it. It wasn't a hugely hard hit, just a little damage. However, following him off as it started to get wetter, Jack Baldwin was in. There you see Jack sitting there. Watch. This is the second Aston Martin. That's Jorge De La Torre going in. He hits hard. See the wheel sitting there. That's Drew Riggins. De La Torre hits up, almost goes over. Riggins got in with some serious pace and ripped that whole right front corner off the car. And that was just the track getting damp, but it was in that very sketchy braking zone into turn four and into the S's.
Unbelievable scenes here. As you can see, the cars now being dragged out of these gravel traps, and we're certainly under a time crunch now. You can see the teams doing their changeover from the Pirelli slicks to the wet weather, the groove tires, but the clock is running.
The clock is running, and this is torrential rain that we are having right now. So things very interesting here suddenly at Mid-Ohio.
Well, some of the field have already elected to come down pit lane, put wet weather tires on, but now we see the full field brought to a stop on the front straightaway behind the safety car. So that strategy may really backfire right now. There you see Nick Johnson, one of the Kias, he'd hit pit lane as well, and he's lost a lot of track position by doing that.
But the right thing to do, clearly, to stop these cars right now. As you can see, there is immense amount of standing water on this circuit. So this was the right thing to do, to pause and then see just what's going to unfold. Well, another update now, folks, just coming in from race control. The decision has been made. The race has been checkered. There's no way they could restart it with this amount of water on the track. And so they have checkered it. And as you can see, they're already starting to wave some of the cars, get them off of that front straight and back into the paddock. So effectively, this 11th round of the championship, abbreviated, bizarre, and complete, Cal. What a race.
What a crazy day. I mean, for the winners here, that'll be the most bizarre motor race they will ever win, that's for sure.
Well, speaking of that, let's take a look at what are sure to be very provisional results at this point, folks. So do keep that in mind. But it appears, depending upon how they scored, Ryan Dial coming in, following in Mr. Nick Tandy's footsteps in his first time in the car, bringing it home with a win. But Johnny O'Connell, talk about saving the day.
Yeah, I mean, finishing second and getting around Mike Skeen, his closest challenger in the championship, Greg, that is a huge day for him.
Absolutely. In the subdivision for GTA for the gentleman drivers, we show the team car to the overall winning car, the 41 effort Porsche of Mike Mills bringing home the win. Jim Taggart making his first start in the series since the opening round at St. Pete, comes home in the second spot in GTA. That, too, one of those Porsche GT3Rs. Good day for them. And Albert Von Turnen-Toxis, the Prince, coming back to run at Mid-Ohio and ends up on the podium. And then we move to the GTS category. Lassen Aschenbach apparently going to get the win there, but the story might be another phenomenal smart run by Alec Udell.
Yeah, he finishes P2, and the key is what a recovery there. They finished third and fourth. Fourth for Mark Wilkins, our championship leader. They caught a bit of a break. Remember, they're one of those teams that did make that pit stop and change tires, but I think they're reverting to the previous lap for the results here today.
So let's hear from our GT winner.
Yeah, definitely one of my stranger wins, and a very wet one at that. But no, I think we obviously had good pace, and I think if it stayed green, we definitely had something for skiing. Car was getting better and better. So no, I mean, first race back in a Porsche for me since St. Pete last year. So every lap I get a little bit more comfortable. But you know, effort racing had a lot of momentum after the win in Toronto. So glad I didn't make myself like too much of an idiot. And managed to come in and give them another win. So we'll make the car a little better for the next race, and I think we'll be strong.
Congratulations, Ryan, and congratulations to our GTS winner, Lassen Aschenbach, when they finally got that little piece of help from the balance of performance, and then his skill on a track like this allowed him to come home with a win. He now has been found by our Jeff Lepper.
That was a crazy race there, but first and foremost, I got to say thanks to Black Dog Speed Shop. Our Chevrolet Camaro was just really fast, and we knew coming in we had a good shot at winning this weekend, and with the balance of performance changes and so forth. So we were expecting to have a good car, especially the fact that after we won last year. So to be able to get the pole this morning and then kind of bring it home during the race was a good feeling. And I feel like it kind of getting our season back on track. It's been a rough year for us, and especially in the points. Really good for the guys. They really deserved it after all the work they've been put through this year. Just really happy to bring it home, and hopefully we can do it again tomorrow.
Well, thanks again, Jeff, and to Lassen Aschenbach and everybody. Great survival mode to bring that one home. Let's take a look now at our CTSV, the Cadillac CTSV move of the race. And I don't think any question there. It was Johnny O'Connell's start once again, 7th to 2nd on that standing start with that amazing launch control and Johnny's abilities. And with him finishing 2nd behind Dial, who's not in the championship, that essentially took him, in terms of points, and that's a big picture, to a win. Awesome job. Now, the Sunoco Hard Charge Award, great story here. Larry Funk, the number 22, Business Advisory Services, BMW N3. He went up 16 places overall from his 21st starting spot in GTS alone, up 16 overall spots to win the Sunoco Hard Charge Award. And Cal, the key at turning point, it was the downpour.
It was. It caught everyone off guard. We knew it was threatening, Greg. The radar was showing it was right on top of us, and all of a sudden, as we headed down into turn 4, you saw cars flying off the racetrack and into China Beach.
That obviously ended up in very short order, bringing the race to a close. However, while the racing was unfolding, of course, the very important Motul Fast Lap Awards. And Cal, these are the awards that for the top two sets the pole for the 12th round of the championship. And Ryan Dial, boy, is he having a day.
He is. He put together a great lap there when he was chasing down Mike Skeen, a 122.286. So he'll grab the pole for tomorrow's race. And Lassen Aschenbach, boy, oh boy, that Camaro is on song this weekend. He grabs the fastest lap in GTS.
Absolutely. So they'll be starting at the front of their respective classes. And, of course, we've got one more round coming at you here from the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Course. It will be round 12. Stay with us. That will be coming at you when we come back. Welcome back to one of America's premier motorsports facilities. It is time for the 12th round of the Pirelli World Challenge GT and GTS Championships. It's the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Challenge presented by StopTech. I'm Greg Creamer again, along with Calvin Fish. As always, Cal, after a somewhat bizarre 11th round of the championship, conditions look a lot better. Huge crowd on hand today. What are you looking for?
Well, I'm looking to see if Johnny O'Connell can repeat that miracle first lap that he put together yesterday. He qualified seventh, was up to second immediately, and ultimately finished in P2. So that was a huge day for him. He thought he was in big problems with the pace of the car, where he was gridded, and today he starts on the second row of the grid. For look for that black caddy to really leapfrog off the start once again.
Yeah, considering Dial isn't in the championship, that was huge for Johnny. Let's take a look at our MoTool Pole Awards, again established by Fast Laps in the 11th round of the championship. Ryan Dial getting that pole award in the effort racing Porsche GT3R in GT. And in GTS, it's Lawson Aschenbach in the number one Black Dog Speed Shop Chevrolet Camaro. He had a wicked quick time during the race, so that's where they will sit. And start we will, as the field now has taken its position. Just a few of the GTS machines at the back, including our pole sitter, winner yesterday, Lawson Aschenbach. Everybody queuing up here. This huge field, Cal, pretty much takes up the entirety of this front straight.
Yeah, they push the front row all the way down towards turn one so you can get the full field lined up here on this front straightaway. But big anticipation here. Look for Johnny O. He's the car second in the left side column there, that number three, the red mirrored black caddy. Look to see what he can do on the initial start here today.
And we are getting word now that everybody has taken a position. Alex Lloyd in the Hawk Performance number 12 Corvette stalled on the roll-off, so there he will either start at the very back or maybe starting from pit lane. So that's out there he is. So he will be at the far back of this field. But we are ready to go. Round 12 for the GT and GTS championships. Just got word, race control, the grid is clear. Revs are starting to come up. Oh, this is going to be fun. It's a launch right into a turn. Dial gets away, but look at O'Connell. Off the launch, around the outside. He's by skiing. I don't know if he's going to get Dial, but a brilliant start. Andy Pilgrim as well, Cal, sweeping around the outside of one.
Yeah, great start by Johnny O, and he has the momentum as they head up towards the brake zone, but Dial protects on the inside line. Palmer, a great start. He's up to fourth in that red mirrored Audi.
Oh, Johnny, thinking about going around the outside, and skiing sensed opportunity. Almost tucked his nose down the inside of the keyhole. Now it is the launch. Everybody cycling in, James Sofronis, then the two McLarens. And boy, I'll tell you, that was a bit of a loss for Thorne once again. They're still struggling to get those cars off the line.
Look at Pilgrim making a big move down the inside of Lazaro. He takes away the fifth position.
Fantastic opening sequence of corners for Pilgrim. He is absolutely dialed right now, chasing Palmer now.
I spoke to Andy this morning. He said, did you see that first lap by Johnny O'Connell? He said, I was just amazed, just watching it up ahead of me. He's trying to do the same thing here today. Great opening lap for Andy.
Now Sofronis. Oh, Lazaro got that inside curb heading into the exit of madness. Loosened that Ferrari up. He gathered it up, but he lost a lot of momentum, Cal.
Yeah, he did, and Sofronis has really come to life quickly here in this second race here of the weekend. So GMG Audi's looking good.
Boy, and Dean Martin looks like he may have got the launch and has jumped into the lead. Atterbury into second, that's that blue number 33. Boy, this is just amazing what's unfolding in GTS. Then it's Lee, then Aschenbach, then the first of the Kias.
Well, Dean Martin qualified ninth in the GTS. Oh, a spin here on the front straightaway. That's Boland goes around.
Oh, and he backed up, collected the rear wing right off the back of Fred Roberts, who's still spinning, and Atterbury forced way off, Cal. That was an attaboy job of driving by him to bring that car back on. Roberts now is wounded. I think Boland, too. Oh, we got a McLaren up. That's Thorne.
He's off up in the keyhole turn number two here, so drama early in the going.
If everybody's able to continue, they Pilgrim. Can. Pilgrim again looking down the inside.
Deep on the brakes, trying to get that position away, but Andrew Palmer said, no, you're not going to have it. This is a great battle here for the fourth spot.
Fantastic. Lazaro, with that loss of momentum, has lost touch with this group. So here's the blanket right here. There's Skeen, then Palmer, the blue and white Audi with the red highlights around the wheel arches, and then Andy Pilgrim. Fantastic, but up front, it is Dial and the number three of Johnny O'Connell as Dean Martin starting to draw away, but now Aschenbach up into second. Lots more to come from Mid-Ohio. We'll be back in a minute. We're back in Mid-Ohio where we are caution and about to go back to green. We'll tell you about the reason for the caution in a minute, but the pace car is in, the Cadillac CTS-V pace car. So it is Ryan Dayal in the 31 effort Porsche right there bringing the field around. Johnny O'Connell in second. Absolutely great launch as always. We're back to green.
Look,
lots of racing to go. And again, Palmer, as you said, Kel, showing the nose to Skeen down into one. Boy, that is a brave move. Skeen giving him room.
Skeen gives him room and Palmer gives him a little bit of room. He didn't lean on him too badly and that gives Skeen the inside line for the braking zone for turn two. But Skeen takes that position. Great stuff here between the two Audis.
Boy, absolutely. And the guy that this caution. Oh, a bump
contact.
There. That's Petey Cunningham.
Bentley to the inside and an Audi, the meat and the sandwich there.
Oh, boy. And I think that was Jeff Courtney, the car that Petey got into. It looks like something may have happened to Petey's car. So problems there. This brings Lazaro back in. Remember, before we went to break, he lost touch with that group. And the caution is helping him out.
Absolutely. And you'd have. Oh, here comes Butch Leitzinger. He hasn't had the best of starts here. Spoke to him this morning, he said, takes a while for this Bentley to come to life. They run over in Europe, but they have tire blankets, tire warmers to get the car up to life early. He said, we don't have that luxury here.
Yeah, this has been a great track for them as well, though. They said they this track, this car is pretty well suited to it. There is maybe the story of the race thus far. Dean Martin, that picture car is East Ford Mustang. He has just won the Optima Batteries Best Standing Start Award, going from ninth to first. By the end of the first lap, Cal, that start must have been spectacular. Lawson Aschenbach has reeled him in right now, but what a launch for Martin.
Well, Dean Martin has rebounded in the best way because he had the off yesterday, remember, and was way down in the points coming out of the race yesterday, but he came into this championship round really in a tight battle with Mark Wilkins trying to chase him down, and the finish yesterday put him further behind, but this is the sort of run that he needs here today to get back in contention.
Yeah, and Wilkinson started third. It's where he was set to start here, and he slipped back just a little bit. Janssen right now, the best place. There he is, right behind Andy Lee. But, boy, look at Aschenbach tucking in. He's going to go for the move.
He looks to the inside, but he's going to be patient here. He realizes he's got a really, really strong car. His early pace yesterday was phenomenal, but a second clear of the rest of the field. So he knows he's got a good car. He knows that Dean Martin is really aggressive. He's not going to give up the lead of this motor race easily.
Here's that long run down the back straight, and there goes Aschenbach looking to the inside through the king. Not there, tucks in now, swings out again. These Camaros have historically been really good on the brakes, but Lawson is citing not just yet.
But I tell you one thing, he wants to win this. Such a huge point swing. If you can get that first position, it's a massive jump between first and second. And with the win yesterday, Aschenbach suddenly realizes, even though that Kia of Mark Wilkins has a massive lead right now, if I can sweep the table the rest of the way for this championship season, I could be in with a shot.
Boy, and the pace these two are setting right now is drawing them clear away from Andy Lee and the rest of this field. Ooh, a little wide there.
Martin's
for Martin.
Wide. Martin is very wide. That allows Aschenbach to get on the power a little bit sooner, but Dean's still protecting that inside line. Doesn't give it to him. Pushes Lawson wide there on the entry to 11.
I think if you went through a list of the most difficult guys to pass in World Challenge, Dean would at least be on it.
I love him, though. I mean,
he's
just aggressive. He's feisty, and that's what it's all about.
On to the front straight one more time. Martin continuing to hang on. That white picture car is East Mustang with Aschenbach in tow.
Yeah, he's looking really good. And right now, Gables is doing a great job there. He's running in the fourth spot. Wilkins is now up to fifth after a mediocre first lap.
Aschenbach now going for it. This is down into the keyhole. He's through, Cal. We have a new leader. It is Lawson Aschenbach out of the keyhole with Martin tucked into second. And there's a look at Thorne as he's trying to work his way up after that early spin. He's got to work through all of these GTS cars. And they set sail. Aschenbach out front.
He's looking really good. But look at that other Black Dog Speed Shop Chevy Camaro sitting there in the top five. That's a great run for Tony Gables here today. He'll be pumped.
We want to talk a little bit about the Black Dog Speed Shop team and Team Chevrolet. They drive these iconic Camaros. They are eye-catching. They are very much recognizable. But for the Black Dog team, well, you'd expect them to have a black, mean paint scheme on these cars.
The great thing about the Chevrolet Camaro is it's got some pretty distinct and pretty unique and bold lines. You know, it's quite edgy. It's not the, you know, those smooth, tight flowing cars. And that's what I think it gives it so much character, because it's got that edgy look to it. And the flat black goes right along with that.
The flat black paint has become kind of a team identifier. We kind of joke flat black dog. And it reminded me of back in the day when guys would, you know, soup up their cars and they didn't have enough money for paint and they just left it with the primer on. stuff. You know, that's actually a pretty cool look.
It's definitely a bit of an iconic style looking car now, you know, because it's flat, it's mean. You know, well, in my mind, I think it scares the competition. But they might see the car coming in the rearview mirror and might go, oh, you know, that's that black dog car again. We got GT caliber guys, you know, in a GTS style program. And I think it sort of screams that sort of mean attitude that we want to have sometimes, you know, and I love it. So I got to say hats off to these guys because it really does look good. And I'm excited to drive it.
And a good look right there at the number 55 in the hands of CEO for the Pirelli World Challenge yesterday, Scott Bove. Today, young 15-year-old Austin Cindric, son of Tim Cindric of Penske Racing, all raising money for the Special Operations Warrior Fund. It's a great story. Every position gained, they make money for a great charity organization. Thanks to the Capaldi Racing Group for helping make this happen. We're going to step away. Here's a look at our class leaders.
Machines and their manufacturers span the planet. This is no spec series. Diversity breeds excellence and brings battle. Ride with the best and test the iconic circuits of North America. No pit stops, no quarter. The world watches and knows this is how racing should be.
Up and over the roller coaster ride. That is the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Course heading in just a few laps to the checkered flag. Ryan Dell, the effort racing Porsche GT3R number 31, continues to lead from pole. It has been a fantastic run for this man here at the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Challenge presented by StopTech Cal. Just an amazing run in yesterday's race with the bizarreness of the weather. Today, about as diametrically opposed to yesterday's race as you can get, and no change in the front. Dell has just been on.
He has been on it. It was a crazy race finish here yesterday. Ryan said, one of the strangest races I've ever been involved in, but right now you can see him comfortable at the front. But what a day for Mike Skeen. He's running in second, big points there. And Johnny O'Connell, the man he's chasing in the championship, sits back in the fifth position today.
Yeah, big opportunity for Skeen. That Hawk Performance Audi right there behind him, Anthony Lazzaro in the R-Ferry Automotive Group, Ferrari of Ontario. Number 61, 458 Italia. Then it is the number 21 Global Motorsports Group, Thermal Club, and Spider Audi of young Andrew Palmer having a very strong run, as you said. Then O'Connell and Pilgrim, the two Cadillacs, number 3 and 8 in 5th and 6th. Sophronis and the team Audi from Global Motorsports Group in 7th. Butch Leitzinger and the Bentley having a very solid run, that Breitling Mobile 1 Bentley in the 8th spot.
Yeah, that Bentley has looked really strong here in the late going. He just didn't have the best of starts, best of first laps, but has fought back well. And I think that Bentley is really going to be on the podium before the end of this season.
Alex Figge in the McLaren making a return after missing the two Toronto rounds after that huge shunt at Road America, now runs in the ninth spot. Michael Mills, the team effort car in the number 41 entry, is currently leading the GTA subcategory for our gentlemen drivers. But Albert von Turnen-Taxis, the German nobleman, he is coming on in that number 24. That car, that Lamborghini Gallardo, is hooked up as we are now on our final lap, Cal.
Final lap. Dial has a nice, comfortable margin up front, and I don't see any traffic immediately in front of him. Here we're looking at the GTS leader. That's Lawson Oschebach. Janssen runs in second. Dean Martin has been dropped to third, and Wilkins is up to fourth. He's had a great few laps here and has really made some big points.
Absolutely. I mean, he had dropped back as far as 8 from his third starting spot, and Mark just put his head down, and he really started to haul that put on the brakes.org Kia Optima from the Kinetic team, the Kia Motors America program, back into contention. More huge points implications, isn't it?
Absolutely, and every point is critical as we're winding down on this championship season. After this round here today, just 4 more rounds of this championship. So when you're the championship leader, you're just trying to tick those boxes as you get through the season.
Meanwhile, here is the man, Ryan Dell, up and through the exit of madness. That is a turn number 9 that right at the apex, it just drops away. Great car control required down there. This guy has it up through turn 11, into the carousel one last time. There's Skeen, then Lazzaro, then Palmer. So that gives you an idea of the margins. But for Ryan Dell, he has been spot on and comes onto the front straight. He's gonna do the sweep. Effort Racing picks up rounds 11 and 12 here at the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Course. Skeen, an important run to second. Lazzaro up into third. Just a fantastic run by the Scotsman.
Absolutely. Ryan put on a tremendous performance here today. A big day for skiing, a big weekend for Lawson Aschenbach. The championship looked to be out of reach, but getting two full points here on the weekend will be big for his championship charge. But look at Nick Johnson. He's not giving up either. He came into this round second place in points to his teammate Mark Wilkins, and another strong podium run for Kia.
Yeah, I think Johnson had designs of maybe doing something, and then these two GT cars got in between, and that allowed Lawson to have a little bit of breathing room. He brings the Black Dog Speed Shop, number one across the line, sweeping as well. So a couple of sweeps in the categories here this weekend, and it's a potential triple sweep if Mike Mills can hang on. He won GTA yesterday in round number 11, so he might just have an opportunity here to make it happen. But there is Ryan Dial, winner once again here at Mid-Ohio. So with Dial's second win of the weekend, let's take a look at our provisional results. Dial gets the win, but I'll tell you what, the real story is the points battle behind him.
It really is. Mike Skeen's second podium of the weekend, and you see O'Connell there in the fifth spot. So not a great day for O'Connell, but coming in here, they thought they'd be in trouble. They're probably pretty satisfied with that result.
Absolutely. Now let's take a look at, first we want to mention in GTA, once again, Mike Mills getting another win. Great weekend for effort. But how about GTS, Aschenbach running the table?
Yeah, Camaro coming back strong. Lawson needed to, and he did it exactly right. Two wins here. Great day for Kia, though. Nick Johnson in second spot, and Wilkins on the final lap getting by Dean Martin for that crucial podium position.
So that's the story on the results. And of course, up front, it was a great day, a great effort by Effort Racing and Ryan Dial. Let's get down to Victory Circle and Jeff Lepper.
Yeah, full effect for Effort Nation. Man, that was a quite hard race. Restarts are never very fun, but Effort Racing, Porsche 911 GT3R, excellent. Double-double for the team, so really happy. Hopefully I'm back at the next one, but it's not easy with the restarts. You know, I think it takes us a couple laps to get going, but my brother's going through some big surgery tomorrow, so this one's for him.
Well, truly a great day for Ryan, but as we said, Cal, it's the points behind him. That's the story.
Well, O'Connell continues to lead, but Skeen really tightens things up with those two podiums. Less than 100 points now, the margin with four rounds remaining, but a great battle for third between Lazaro, Palmer, and Pilgrim.
And a great battle in GTA, our subcategory for our gentlemen drivers. And once again, Mike Mills putting together a superb day for effort. Huge weekend for him in terms of points.
Absolutely. With that double victory, he extends the point lead over Henrik Hedman and Dan Knox sitting there in third.
Now let's take a look at our GT manufacturers points presented by Nissan. Cadillac still hangs on, but Audi, Ferrari, Porsche, all of them squeezing that margin just a little bit, making that battle a lot more intense. Now let's go to our Cadillac CTSV move of the race. It was a beauty, and it was for the lead. It was Lawson Aschenbach making the move on the fast starting Dean Martin and picking up the lead. That is our Cadillac CTSV move of the race. And of course, that took Lawson right to the win. It was a sweep for him as well. Might just bring him right back into the plan in terms of points, and he is now with Jeff Lepper.
Well, Lawson Aschenbach, two in a row, has got to feel pretty good after your season.
You know, I got to say hats off to everybody at Black Dog Speed Shop. I mean, these guys have been working so hard. We've had a rough year, everybody knows that. The series had the hardest job in the world of balancing all the cars, and fortunately they gave us some help for this weekend, and we came in really excited. We love Mid-Ohio. The car was great here last year, and this Team Chevy Camaro was just flawless all weekend. So really excited about the win. It kind of puts us maybe back in that championship run. You know, we're not giving up yet. We know we have a mountain to climb again, but we're gonna get everything we have. You know, it ain't over till it's over, right? So thank you.
Well, it was a great day for Aschenbach, but how about those GTS driver points, Cal?
Well, it's two Kias up front. Great weekend for Mark Wilkins. A big lead right now over his teammate Nick Johnson, but with the way the points are set up, anything can happen with four rounds to go. In a very tight battle, that double victory for Aschenbach, he moves up to third, and a really tight battle with Dean Martin.
Let's take a look at the GTS manufacturer's points presented by Kia. Yes, Chevrolet with Aschenbach's couple of wins here has closed up on Ford, but with the Fords being behind, Kia has actually stretched that margin just a little bit, so a good run for them. Our Sunoco Hard Charger Award, well, that goes to the number 97 of Mitch Landry in the VersaCrane Deep South of Ford Mustang from the Motorsports Development Group of 14 spots after starting right at the back of the pack. Great day for him. And Cal, our Kia turning point probably has to be the standing start because of who it brought into play in terms of this points battle.
Well, the Cadillacs, if they have an advantage left for that race car, it is the standing starts. And boy, oh boy, Johnny O'Connell, once again, a sweet start. Pilgrim today also got a great one. They got up in that front pack and they got some big points.
They did indeed. Now let's take a look at our Motul Fast Lap Award winners. These are very prestigious, and it also earns a point as well. Ryan Dial in GT in that effort Porsche getting Fast Lap once again, and Lawson Aschenbach in the number one Black Dog Speed Shop Camaro nails the Motul Fast Lap in GTS. As we take a look at the Kia Rewind, we're going to look ahead just a little bit. Next couple of rounds, Sonoma. That is an awesome track as well.
The rolling hills in the Napa Valley. We have elevation change here, but it's certainly very pretty out on the West Coast, and the championship is really tightening up, Greg.
It's going to be a fierce battle. Make sure you join us there. Thanks so much for Calvin Fisher, for Jeff Leppert. I'm Greg Creamer. Thanks for joining us here at Mid-Ohio. Take care, everybody.